Prodigal Steve returns to Earthlock Festival of Magic. How's it going, everybody? Last week, we made it through the sewers, and I was under the impression that I might be slightly underleveled after we acquired our new robot friend here. I don't necessarily think that's the case anymore, because I'm now aware of the level cap. Apparently, the level cap on any given character is 20. So I think we're probably okay. I think I just had a bad setup for that boss fight. I don't think I'm going to use Pat or Olia this episode. I obviously need to get them up to level with the rest of the party. And I think I'm going to do that off camera. That'll also give me an opportunity to learn what Pat is about. I haven't used him at all. Instead, off camera, I farmed some bonds. Amon and Ive now have a level 5 bond. Taika and Nart have a level 5 bond. And Amon and Taika, and then Ive and Nart are at level 4 bond. We also have a fair number of talent points that need to be spent, and I've redone our talent boards. I also did finish this quest, the 25 ghost tags, and the reward for that was this perk talent right here. Guarantees that the next strike is a critical if the last strike KO'd the target. So basically what I'm thinking here is if we use Taika's elemental attacks, kill an enemy on the first attack, then her area of effect that hits all enemies will crit all of them on the next turn. So I've switched her over to a bunch of magic talents and then some agility. That seemed okay. I do think I'm still going to switch her stance to the immunity stance on occasion because I have picked up lightning as one of her abilities. So she now has a lightning attack. Yeah, there we go. So she can do a multi-target range attack that inflicts electro damage, which is exciting. And now she can also make our party immune to a lightning attack. So I think that's going to be exciting. I did explore outside of Suvia a little bit. And that's actually where I got lightning. I fought one of, like, a giant crab with, like, one other, like, beetle, I think. That's where I learned lightning. And then I tried to fight, like, four of those beetles, and they party wiped me. So that was exciting and also a little embarrassing. But we're gonna bring Pat back to the House of the Owltide now. I assume that's what we're supposed to be doing. Right, okay. So this guy is still talking about astronomy. I don't know if he's going to actually be useful later, but I figured I would check in with him on our way through. Let's just head up and talk to Lady Lumia. Hey, I found your machine. And then I broke it, and then I fixed it again. Lady Lumia, here's the machine. Rip. It's operational? It's more than that, High Owl. It speaks. It is sentient. Sentient? Brab, boop, doop, doop, sentient. Well, well, intriguing. What happened? Adrian, Railwind, bip, bip. We found Pat. Yeah, I know, Pat. We found him in a warehouse with a great wave guard watching him. This cult, this Adrian woman, they're working with the Great Wave. Commander Locke probably intends a power grab now that the General is gone. We have to warn my father. This is not good. I will send for him. This cult, we've gathered some knowledge on them while you went after the machine. They call themselves the Nanook Order. Nanuch? Either way. It's a covert sect that spawned from the Idolus monks in Anu. I do not know why they've come all the way to the Suvian Empire from Nadir, but working in league with the new commander, they might want to overthrow the Suvian Empire, cripple the Great Wave, or worse, destroy Suvia. Why? We know little about the Nanich Order, but their Eidolon religion runs deep, could be their motif. What's Eidolon? Like Lysisophy here in the Suvian Empire, Eidolon is the main belief system in Anu. Their mythology holds the lost civilization, the Valvers, as the custodians of Umbra, like you look to Lys for guidance. They believe the stories of the Valvers are real? The Eidolist monks believe in them, metaphorically at least. The followers of the Nanich Order, on the other hand, they seem to take the legends quite literally. Speaking of legends, this old Discomon, I might have found trace of it in an old manuscript about the rumored engineers. It is said they rose up against their masters before the deadly halt occurred. This disc might shed new light on the manuscript. I have made a sketch so you can have the disc back, but do keep it safe. I'm still unsure why the Nanich Order wants it. I have a feeling Uncle Benjo knew about the disc. I'm sorry I do not have a clearer answer. But make no mistake, you must stop Commander Locke and this Adrian lady. The feathers rustle, the fate of Suvia is in your hands. You are the only ones who can stop whatever is coming. We win the Festival of Magic tournament in the Great House of the Wave Arena, we can get to Commander Locke. Go with them, Pat. Whatever you truly are, I have a feeling you'll be of great help. Fly swiftly now, friends. Alright. Arena time. Let's do this. I honestly expected more story this episode, less, combat. Oh, hang on, I can feel a sneeze coming. Okay. Hear, hear, the Festival of Magic has now officially begun. Exciting announcement there. All right, well, let's go join the tournament, shall we? All right, the door's over here. Always fools me, because typically in RPGs of this style, you just walk to the bottom of the screen and that's the exit. Not so in that room, and it throws me off. Oh, hey. Oh, no, never mind. I thought our astronomer friend was gone. I like this zigzag that I have to do since I'm playing on a keyboard. I can't just tilt an analog stick in the correct orientation. Okay, well, is this the party configuration we want? I think it'll be fine. We might want to switch back to our level 5 bonds, though. Just do that. Because what's that give us? Cloak. Ice text that we don't use. That's what's important. The plus 25% ammo damage. But honestly, this might be better. If for no other reason, the HP. Like, healing potions healing 25% more. Like, if no matter what, we can zombie our way through the arena if we have to. Because I made almost 50 healing elixirs. So these enemies can't handle my strongest potions. Presumably this is the direction that we need to go. This was where the arena was, right? Festival of Magic shenaniganry. Alright, well, sounds like we're going to be defeating Vanessa home. Okay. Welcome to the Festival of Magic and the Ultimate Tournament. You ready? Ready as ever. You have the token from the Zaber Tournament? Nope, not yet. To compete in the final Festival of Magic Tournament, you must win at your district tournament in Zaber. Okay. Well, that is exciting. Okay, good to know. I suppose it would have been a little too easy if we just had to walk two buildings over and then do a tournament and then confront the main villain, huh? Well, back to our warp point then. Maybe we can actually warp to Zaber now, because I'm pretty sure the warp option for Zaber has been grayed out, like, for a long time. I wish we could just warp from any statue and we didn't have to come back here every time, but no, we cannot. Okay. This is probably the closest warp point then. Head down this way, shall we? Oh, right. I still have the ghost thing on. All right. I don't want to fight any more ghosts right now. I don't really want to fight anything right now, if I'm being honest. So I'm just gonna, like, run past all these crabs. I don't even get experience from these enemies anymore because we're too high of a level. Like, even if I fight, you know, six enemies at a time, I still get zero experience. But it is irrelevant because we are back in Zaber now. Which is actually nice for raising bond levels. The fact that you don't gain experience. That way keeps you from, like, over-leveling parts of your party. Alright, where's our tournament then? Is it up here? Yeah, it's gotta be. I wonder if you can end up fighting ghosts in the tournament if we use Amon. We want to fight. Do we? Sure, rules. The tournament is 5 rounds of combat, win it in 5 battles, and you will gain gold rank. The more battles you take, the lower the rank you will achieve. Your inventory is limited to a tournament inventory. We want to make this a contest. Look out for chests on the arena floor. Win all rounds here, and you'll get a token that will allow you to enter the final tournament at the Festival of Magic in Suvia. Please sign your name here. For you, Uncle. Okay. Let's do it. Sure. Can I just go in then? Oh. Probably should have used the save point that was right there. Now that I'm thinking about it. Good job, self. Okay, well, hopefully it won't matter. Yeah, start the round. Okay. Can I, like, just gather all these jerks together at once? Because that'd be, like, ideal. We've fought these pirates before, assuming they're the same pirates as last time, like... Oh. Hmm. Arena inventory, or tournament inventory, apparently, extends to your ammunition. I hate that. Okay. Well. Still do that. That is not as much damage as I would like. That is the one bad thing about Taika's ability is it spreads the damage, I think, relatively equally across all enemies. So the more enemies there are, the less damage she does to each individual one. Oh man, and that's just like C A the pirate A B B C. Wow, yeah, alright. Can we haste Amon and maybe get an action in there a little bit earlier? Might as well Electro Lance the one that's marked. It's not that much damage, but with 6 of them, it could add up. Okay, I hate that. And like to inflict some status elements, if at all possible. No. We want to save this for when we really need full party heals. Ive, you're killing me here. Let's go ahead and Quake, because that could stun them. Yeah, all right, so that's knocking out two attacks on this round. So that helps a ton, actually. Get you killed. Now I'm thinking we might be a little over-leveled, but I guess it's probably going to get harder the further we move through this. All right, you have two Omri. I think you just rest. Mark the pirate, the blaster, I guess, whatever you want to call it. And then, oh, they just barely haven't gotten to their bond level. All right, that's fine. No, not fire breath, we want Quake. Was hoping for another stun there, if I'm being honest, but it's all right, I guess. I think it would take a really long time for these units to actually kill us. Like, they're not doing that much damage to us, so... No, they're doing like 100 damage and we have thousands of HP. So I feel, you know, pretty okay about our chances. At least in this fight, it might just take a little while to get them all killed because we have garbage ammo. I think I'm just gonna stop stunning them and just try and throw out as much damage as I can. And the more we kill, the better Take is gonna do, actually. That one should die to his burn, either this turn or next. Okay, are they resistant to fire? Is that what's going on here? Is that why we're doing so little damage? Or are those just like the actual weakest units? Probably a bite will get the job done. No, not even close. Okay, fair enough. Heal yourself, Nart. I tend to favor healing the healer if I can. Okay. Well, that was easy. Ive is, like, almost at a level. We should probably open this chest, huh? What do you got for me? Healing Balm plus. Oh. Okay. Right, yeah, so I don't have my 50 elixirs that heal, you know, 1200 HP. Alright, neat. That's fine. Okay, I remember these guys, and I kind of hate them. I would like all of you to clump together, though, if at all possible. Sure, I'll fight all 8 of you at once. This bothers me not. Like, you're annoying? But it's not the end of the world. Especially if we could just do that. Okay, that did a decent amount of damage. And he has 3 more actions left to do basically that exact same thing. So I think what we do is kill these things because they can buff. Yeah, alright, so we stunned one of them, so now we'll silence the other. And then they shouldn't be able to do anything. Don't berserk yourself. I did not approve of that. I like that they're all burning as well. That's helpful. Yeah, get down here where Taka can stun you with Quake. This matters very little to me. I guess we could just try a regular Spud Blast this time. Yeah, I would say that got the job done. I wonder if we get to keep this stuff. Like the money and items that we find here during the battles. Okay. So we don't get any... Oh, do we get... Was this chest here before? What in the world is that? Restores all armory to all targets. Okay, well, I like that. So there were, what, 5 rounds? Alright, so these are desert enemies. Mostly. Yeah. Let's do this. Okay, this might actually be a great time for Ives' special, actually. I think most, if not all, of these enemies do special attacks, or physical attacks, rather, so they should all be susceptible to being trapped. So yeah, let's try that. I'm a little worried that the beetle, like the big one, is immune to Quake. So I might just want to do lightning here. I mean, that wasn't great, but I'll take it. Now we're just gonna sit. Oh, you were not as susceptible to ice as I expected you to be. Okay. Well, I guess we can do that. That's a guaranteed kill. We don't need the health regen yet, like the full party heal. And we can probably get our bonds back up by the time we... need them. These things are a lot tankier than I thought. What is that thing doing? I don't know what the dragon thing is doing, but I don't approve of it. I know that. There we go. What's that? Use an explosive attack. That way it'll set the trap off, even if it doesn't do a physical attack. Joke's on you. I can still cause you to explode in a giant ice ball, whether you want to or not. Might as well heal Ive here. There we go. Easy enough. Bond up? All right. Well, I could certainly live with that. Does that give us full bond? No. No, it does not. I don't see another chest anywhere. Nope. Scratch that. One ground frost. Freezes the target to the spot, preventing them from using melee abilities. You telling me that we're gonna fight a melee boss? Is that what you're telling me? It seems like it's what you're telling me. Oh, these are just dudes from the swamp, right? Like, that's not bad. We fought these things forever ago. They can poison, though, and I kind of hate that. But this might just kill all of them? No. Okay. There we go. Silence that thing. Because it's gotta die. The sooner the better. Not really the kind of damage I was looking for there. It's alright, though. We can use Nart to cure poison, so that does not bother me. We just need to, like, wait it out a little bit. What about just a regular old Spud Blast? Okay, that thing is now deceased. Enjoy that. You're probably in most need of having your poison cure. It missed? Excuse me? Maybe just regular Lance? Obviously we want to do fire with Taka. I would love to burn all of these things. Oh yeah, we probably shouldn't even try to cure right now, since they're just gonna be spamming their poison attacks anyway, huh? We should probably just focus on healing if we can. Alright, well, this is Amon's time to shine. Heal yourself, Nart. How's Electrolance do against these things? 236. Are they immune? Yeah, I just thought about that. Plant enemies tend to be immune to Earth in this game. Okay. Well, that's my bad. Should've just stuck with using Fire Breath. At least it stunned one of them. Don't blind me. Oh, you are the worst. Still killed you, though. Was it worth it? Probably just regen on Taka here. We're still doing fine HP-wise, so I'm not what you would consider to be concerned about our present situation. Electrolance was 236, that's 380. I think that might be better even with the chance of electrocute. Are you actually... No, okay, you can still bite. That's fine. I wish you hadn't glanced, though. Still. Got that thing killed, which is important. Oh, yeah, alright, so that thing is probably dead to the burn. I hate that you have an AoE ability to poison me. That's exciting. I enjoy that a lot. Not being at all facetious when I say that. Alright, Nart's just gonna have to regen Omri. Taka is also going to have to regen Omri, which is what she should have done last time. Now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, just get the guaranteed kill, that's fine. So far this isn't difficult, it's just like a war of attrition mostly. You just have to be able to outlast all of these enemies, and it turns out, you know, if you're a high enough level, poison me all you like isn't really gonna make a difference. Probably should have switched that. That way maybe Taika and Ive could have killed this other one, but Fire Breath might do it anyway. Yeah. Since it was a single target that did a just ridiculous amount of damage. Okay. Fourth chest and final round. What do you got for me? Sweet Dreams. What in the world does that do? Applies sleep to all targets. Okay. What do we have new in the bestiary? Oh, Little Marvel Yellow. I honestly thought these two were the same. They're functionally the same. Like, they have the same strengths and weaknesses, so... that's fine. Alright, what do you got for me in round 5? Okay. I'm gonna open this real quick. It goes boom. Damages all targets with physical exploding damage. Okay. We might as well use this stuff, right? Like, during the tournament? Although, like, how hard are these things, like, these two gonna be to kill, really? Maybe a little bit harder than I expected. Right, we'll heal Ive. I kind of want to do Quake. Just because it might stun them. Also, it did do a ludicrous amount of damage, which I appreciate. Alright, just stack all of the... don't trap me. I really wish we could use Fire Blast S+. I guess we should have just used Taika's special completely for those two, because now she's not going to have enough, like, they aren't going to have enough bond units to, use any of her attacks, I don't think. Oh no, she can still use Water Bomb. Oh hey! Oh no, that was just the regular DOT. Probably get the kill there. Yeah. Good enough. Why not? No reason not to at this point. This is pretty much a foregone conclusion. That did not count as a melee attack, apparently. I mean, that's fine. Still gonna explode that ice trap anyway. Ooh, a fancy chest. Battles 1-5, $1,000, double turn recipe, whirlwind, accelerate field. Wow, we got a lot of stuff, actually. Okay. Sure. Gladly take that. And then immediately save. Okay. Applies haste. Who's that for, though? Cloaks the caster in shadow, preventing them from being directly targeted, increases damage from melee attacks, but decreases the caster's speed. That looks like it's a Mon. It's got, like, the sword. Defense expertise, is that Olia? Gain a double turn if missed by an enemy attack. Okay. Applies evasion, plus 300% evasion stat to the party. Range attack that inflicts magical air damage. Okay, well, Amon does have talent points here. So yeah, you know what? Why not give him cloak? Take. You did not get any new abilities, unfortunately. That might actually be good on her, but I think we'll wait and think about using double turn for a little bit, at least until I see the recipe and I know exactly what it's going to take to make more of it. Yeah, so we'll give her tripwire, because why wouldn't we? Gnart can have whirlwind. Is that an ability for his... He has an attack for his healing stance now? This is the best day of my life. Oh, we can actually make those, the double turn talents as well. It does not look like we got to keep the items that we got from the in-battle chests, like the explosion attack thing, etc., etc., but that's fine, I guess. Alright, well, we'll head back to Plumpet real quick. I should apply talents to the rest of the party. Yeah, we have, like, a bunch of talent points to spend. Amon kind of just needs... He needs another... Resilience, I guess? Probably isn't really going to matter. But that's fine. Take a... I think we're, like, mostly out of... Magic? Yeah, we have one. You know what? I think she gets it. She's got agility, agility... Agility, sure. We'll give her another agility. Right, not enough talent points. Fair enough. I should replace that. Since she doesn't really use fire attacks, I should swap that out with something, but I don't know what I would want to swap it out with. All right. So we can't double them up. Fair enough. All right. Probably should have seen that coming, if I'm being honest, but... I think I want another... Precision on her? Maybe might... Yeah, that's fine, I guess. Alright, Gnart. I guess I should have saved that last magic for him. For symmetry's sake. Fire Master is definitely not something that he requires. He has all of his ability slots used. want to give him more defensive stuff? We probably want more armor than resilience, right? Since we have Taka? Sure. Definitely don't need Firemaster on her. You know what, I'm just gonna ignore that talent point on Olya for now until I go back to start using her again. Okay. Well, we probably want to keep those pairs for when we go to the next arena, right? Oh, hey, and we can warp to Zaber now. Let's go to Suvia. Head over to the next Colosseum. I wonder if we could have done the Zaber tournament at basically any time. And I just waited until like the literal last possible minute. Alright, what's up, boss? Festival Magic in the Ultimate. We are ready. Here's our token. Literally just got it. I have a feeling this is going to be substantially more difficult. So we'll see how this goes. And we'll hope that I don't get wiped. Okay, I don't see any chests to start here. Looks like it is also 5 rounds. These enemies don't seem especially terrible, but it is going to be annoying trying to gather them all together. Although I guess if they're all just going to come to me. Never mind. Turns out it's going to be really easy to gather them all together. Oh, okay, but that is a lot of them, though. I guess we use Fire Breath since she has the Firemaster talent. Oh! She gets a second level ammunition this time. That's good. Glacier Beetle, huh? Well. If I had to guess, I would say that glacier beetles are probably weak to fire? Yeah, that'll do it. Okay. Why does Amon not get... Okay. That's strange. Sand beetle, shimmer bug. Are shimmer bugs weak to water? Let's find out. Weak enough. That is a long line of enemies. Oh, this only affects one enemy. Well, that's substantially worse than I initially thought it was. You know what? I'm actually going to try and change Nart's stance here. If he could do magic buffs instead of healing, that might make this a lot easier for us. I wish I could see all of my party and also all of the enemies at a like decent angle. I guess this will have to do. Yeah. Use a magic focus. If you could kill this thing, Amon? That's fantastic. Thank you, sir. Fire lands on the other glacier bug. Should get a kill. No. Okay. Well, that'll definitely kill the glacier bug anyway. Maybe we should have used the lightning instead, though? I feel like lightning should be more effective against bugs. Against all flying enemies. Is she gonna get three turns? Because that'd be dope. She just got double turned twice. It's attack focused, since Amon's probably not gonna be using his water blast all that often. See if we can't just get rid of these, you know, ankle biters here in the front. I think we just use regular lance. And then, okay, sure. Had to think about it a minute. Regular lance. Okay, she does not get three turns. Fair enough. Hit these two with lightning. That was incredible. Taika. That was beautiful. Where's my chest, though? I should check what items I have. Two cores and two horns. Healing ball. We have Kiss of Lys, so apparently they're expecting some of our party to die. Then you're just gonna give me healing elixirs, huh? That's disheartening. Oh. I already hate this. Looks like they're all heading in this direction, so we might as well open this up. Wait for all eight of them to gather. Okay. Were these things weak to fire? I really should learn the enemies better. Oh, they're immune to fire. Well, that's annoying. Right, we might just do attack focus then. That way we can at least do this. 3,000 damage crit. Are any of you immune to quake? Yeah, a lot of you are, but we did still get some stuns out of it. It's really hard to see what's going on with 8 enemies. Should probably start healing with Gnart here, huh? Yeah. That is gonna remove his buff. But probably now is the time to switch his stance. It was probably between battles, if I'm being honest. That's alright. Not quite as much damage as I was hoping for. I know the ones in the front at least have fire immunity, but I was hoping for some big plays there in the back row. I don't know why I said it like that. Row. It's not how you pronounce that word in any language, to my knowledge. Not really the heal I was looking for there, Gnart. Any second now. Okay, there we go. Takes it a minute to think through the turn order sometimes. Let's get rid of that cultist in the back. I don't like that thing. How do you guys feel about lightning damage? You're immune. Are you immune to everything? Is that why I was so annoyed at the sewers? I feel like the answer is yes. Amon, like, that poison is really, like, wrecking his life. Do fire? They got a kill. So I wonder if on her next turn, if she'll crit all of them. Although she's allegedly zombified? I don't know what that is, but I hate it. Alright, you know what? Yeah. This seems worthwhile. 1200 damage in one turn. Alright, we might want to throw out the, like, super cure. Don't put her to sleep. I want to make sure that this thing dies to its burn, so I'm just gonna, like, kill it outright. And I guess start working on this one since it's a little bit weaker. Does this hit everybody? It does hit everybody, but I would rather do this. Because that should actually wake Taka up. Or not. Okay, apparently that just did nothing. Can you not, like, kill one of my characters? That'd be, like, super. I have to use a healing elixir here. A little bit earlier than I would have... You care to explain to me what just happened there? Why is it that using a potion on my... Is it because they're infected? Is that, like, a status effect that was just never explained to me? You couldn't have just given me the kill there. I hate these enemies. I genuinely hate them. Yeah, great. You're electro-immune. I honestly, like, do not care at all. Is that gonna kill him? No, that healed him. Okay, so, like... No idea why. Is it because she was zombified? Is that the thing? Who knows? I genuinely just, like, want all of these things to be dead now. I continue to not care about you being electro-immune. It's like, I don't know why you have to tell me that. Cure your poison, because that'd be super. I don't know what that other symbol is, but sure. I guess just bite. Okay. Well, that went, like, about as poorly as it could have gone, I imagine. Alright, right, we've opened both chests. I do really wish we could heal outside of battle. like with abilities. Just use like all of our healing balm pluses. Do I want to change our stances at all? I don't think so. But I'm pretty sure we have to fight all eight of them at the same time to beat the arena. These things shouldn't be immune to Quake. Alright, that one's stunned, so let's try and get rid of this one before it starts buffing units. I hate the glance, that's alright. We can silence it though. And if we silence it, it actually can't do anything. Like, way more fish enemies than I thought there were. Yeah, no, I get it. Why do you get two turns? Like, you can't possibly be that fast. Like, a flying fish cannot possibly be... Oh, Nart's confused for a turn. Great. Excellent. We have to kill this thing as well. Alright, well, we got a stun. Now we're gonna have to weather a gigantic storm again. I guess I should have switched Taika's stance. I really wish that she could apply her immunity buff to everybody. I'm also getting like really tired of watching all of the enemy attack animations. It's like super annoying. Alright, well at least that thing's dead. So that makes our life probably substantially easier. I think we need to save it for Nart, honestly. As much as I want to use her ice trap, oh, that's not a lot of damage at all. Yeah, I think we need to keep healing everybody as much as we can. It's like, that's such a huge full party heal. Being able to do it, like, three more times or whatever. I like the miss. I hate that. I'm just gonna, like, get up and walk away, and you guys can call me when I get to attack again. One more enemy dead. I'm like doing my best to keep Taika off death's door. Alright, you know what? Use a healing balm 2 plus on yourself. I think it really matters which one of the fish that we kill. They're both, like, super annoying. As is that. Oh, no, 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 no. don't want to waste their special level, so might as well keep healing while we can. It does not seem like fish are especially weak to lightning, which is like actually a little infuriating to me. Like, it makes no sense. A lot of the elemental things in this game are just like, shrug. I don't know, why would that work? Like, why would fire enemies be weak to water? They're weak to ice, obviously. How did she get put to sleep, is my question. Alright, well, they're officially out of bond level now. And Jake is confused. Okay, well, she's no longer confused. That's exciting. Please, just get rid of these stupid fish. I'm no longer having fun with the arena. Like, this is actually just tedious and annoying. Water blast, I guess? Like, those things should be weak to water, right? They use fire attacks. Probably doesn't mean that they're actually weak to water, but you know, whatever. Still don't have the Omri, huh? Okay, well, I think we're gonna get out of this battle substantially better than we got out of the last one. As long as something doesn't go horrendously wrong here. This should kill them both. If it doesn't, I'm going to be a little surprised. Okay. Sure. We're getting like a ton of levels, actually. Oh, that was only the third round. Okay, well, let's do this. This seems like it's going to be an actual nightmare. I don't even know what those fish things are, but I already hate them. Oh. All right, well. Really wish I could use Fire Blast with Amon on that, ice-looking thing there in the back. Okay. Well, that should get the job done. Y'all immune to Earth like everything else in this arena is? At least we got one of them. Okay, well, she doesn't use melee attacks anyway, so whatever. Regen Ive again? I just want to absolutely guarantee that that thing's dead. I hate the burning, though, admittedly. That is not a lot of damage. I really don't think... Alright, you know what? Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna change stance. This is fine. This bothers me not. Regen Taka. Amon, could you water blast that thing? Okay, that did a pretty good job. Elemental Absorb on these two? Since they will be... Like, Amon and Taka, since they're paired, are immune to burning. They're not immune to fire, but they are immune to burning. So it is slightly less pertinent that they, be protected. I guess we just do Water Blast again? Reapply Drowning? Wish you wouldn't do that. Just use the regular lance. Okay. Instead of trying to do... elemental damage to these things. I'm a little nervous about what the final fight is gonna look like. That thing should go down relatively soon. Nobody really needs to be healed, so we might as well try some damage. Yeah, okay. That worked surprisingly well. Like to be able to have Nart's heal ready for our final battle here if I could. So might as well do bond up. Now we might as well do regen. Just to use the last of their special and also heal Ive a little bit. Please kill him. Alright, well. That's fine, I guess. This is stackable, so there's no reason not to do it. I'm obviously going to save Amon and Taka's for the final fight. Use it. Against, okay, 1500 damage, excuse me. You, like, actually get out of this arena right now? That is, you use ice attacks, but you're now weak to fire, of course. Why would that be? I hate the fact that you have to, like, memorize the bestiary. Almost, like, maxed out again. To the point where I am actually going to wait so that Nart can regen her, which is gonna add to their bond, I think. Yes, okay. Alright. Got the job done there. We're actually in a decent spot HP-wise. Toxic Cloud, sure. And I'm definitely going to use all of that stuff. this match unless I have something absolutely better to do every single turn. I hate both of these things. Just looking at them, I can already tell. Up in smoke, huh? Alright. You two are gonna meet me in the center, huh? Kill the wizard, right? Like, that's... Why does the wizard have the sword? You two... make no sense. I don't appreciate what you're doing here. That was some decent damage. Throw in a regen real quick. Excuse me? That is, not what I signed up for. Do want to increase our HP a little bit. And then regen. Joke's on you. Played right into my hand. Alright, more damage. At least one of them is using... melee attacks? Applies poison to all targets. No. That's not something I approve of. I will do that, though. Focus this one down. Just change stance? Throttle whirlwind? You don't have the bond for anything that you have ammo for. Okay. Hilarious. Can you get the kill here, though, for me? Thank you. Stun would be just fantastic, or just like a ton of damage. That's fine too. This was like maybe the easiest fight out of all of them. Okay, gimme. Quick rest, battle focus, confuse, intervene. All right, ton of stuff going on there. Festival Masters. That's right. We did it. Beat the arena. Oh, you got the two sandbags here with us. Yep. Okay. Is this supposed to happen? Now what? I don't like this. Me neither. Look at this melodramatic SOB. I'm surprised. Didn't expect you to make it this far. Amon, you have no idea how long I've searched for you, for your artifact. What in the black sands do you want with the disc? If I get my uncle back, you can have it. Here. I have a better idea. I can just pry it from your cold remains. Sure. No rest for the weary, apparently. Ambushed. Neat. Oh, that's a lot of damage, but at least I have all my ammunition back. Okay, we in this then. Kill this guy first. Amon, please fire blast plus this dude into another dimension. Excuse me? Is this a... Is this scripted that we're gonna lose because we didn't get the... We can do this pep talk at the beginning. I'm beginning to have a sneaking suspicion that this may be scripted to where we lose. Oh yeah, no, okay. We are actually guaranteed to lose this because we're doing zero damage. Fair enough. Well, I'm not gonna play your stupid game. Yeah, there we go. Might as well just wait for that exact thing to happen. This is what we industry types like to call foreshadowing. Now we're setting up a motive to go beat this dude into the dust. Grab the Earth Key and dump them in the canals. Naturally, we got fished out. Friends, how are you feeling? Like crap. Smell like it, too. What happened? Miles found you in the canals and brought you here. You were all out cold. No wonder we smelled. You didn't complain about tramping through the sewer last episode. I failed. They took the disc, they got away. Lumia, the cult and Commander Locke were indeed working together. As I feared. While you were out, I've been digging deep in the archive. The disc you, Amon, something struck me. You look like a desert scavenger, but there's more than my owl eye. But there's more than my owl eyes can see. That magical bracelet you have on you is called an attractor. It also stems from ancient times. I believe your roots stretch far beyond the desert and into the past. This gadget thing? Uncle Benjo has said it belonged to my family. Beyond the desert, what do you mean? That you might actually be a descendant of the fabled engineers. Going through the Libro Ingenarium, the Book of the Engineers, I found more hints about the disc and that attractor. Alas, on torn pages. These devices were rare, but from what I can gather, each engineer clan had them. Are you kidding? Engineer me? What does this mean? Why would Locke want the disc? We are not certain what is myth and what is truth from the times before the planet stopped spinning. Before day and night froze into a standstill, but it's a fact that the attractor can manipulate and control Omri, as it was told the legendary Valifers could. And the disc somehow plays into this. Whether this Nanook order is going at it, it is doing... Whatever this Nanook order is going at, it is doing so in the shadows. There we go, that's how that sentence reads. And we must bring it to the light. Suvi is in danger, we are in danger. My feathers can feel it. Railwind, sunken. The order is going to Railwind? Where, Pat? Rill. Rill, that is an old place name, but I cannot remember. I have it on the tip of my tongue, but no, Rill. Go down to the archive and dig out what Rill is called now. Find out where it is, and I'm sure you'll learn what Railwind is. I heard you were under the spell of devastation at the tournament. I can craft you a Lys Aegis talent that will counter it so you can defeat Ichabo and his mysterious warrior next time. I do not have the ingredients, unfortunately, so you must bring them to me. Tilda down in the archive can help you find out where they might be found. They are Ursoil, Protofire, Omri Electron, and lastly, Arrakis. Hurry, friends, return to me when you have them. Hurry, friends, find this Railwind and Rill, find your Uncle Amon, and stop this cult before it's too late. I sense darkness grows on the horizon. Go. Found item, heal. Ooh, what's that do? Heals 40% of max health? Yes, please. More importantly, though, we need to get to a save point and then end this episode. Actually, no. I don't want to see ghosts. I just now noticed that the doorway looks like an owl. How many times have I been in and out of that building? There we go. Took it a second. That's okay. Yeah, we'll save game. I guess I should have warped to Plumpet and then save, but not really the end of the world one way or another. Okay. There we go. Well, that is going to do it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button. As always, feedback is welcome in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time.